afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome aboard Grapevine Vintage Railroad. You guys excited? Okay, that was a fantastic. That group we brought here from Grapevine, we had to do it a couple of times before they got it right. So you guys are awesome. All right, as we get started today, we have a few rules and a little bit of information to share with you guys, and then I promise I'll be quiet and let you enjoy your train ride. It is extremely unsafe to reach out and try and grab everything, so please do not do that. Those of you seated in our first class coaches, those are the coaches starting with the number 2. You're going to notice there are blinds in some of the windows. And on what was a really pretty blue sky day, it's going to be awfully tempting to lower those blinds and then block out the sun. But we are begging, would you please do not adjust the blinds. Leave them in their full upright open position. Those blinds are actually approaching 100 years old. They are extremely fragile. And if they're damaged, we cannot replace them, so please do not adjust the blinds. Federal law prohibits smoking and the use of vaping devices while on board the train. Our restrooms are located in the first class coaches. Those of you in touring or economy, the coaches that start with 18 are going to need to cross through the vestibules to get to these other cars. Please be very, very careful when you're up and moving about the train, and especially as you cross over the gap between the coaches. You'll see 2 yellow lines painted on the floor. Take 1 big giant step, cross over both of those lines at the same time. That is the safest way to navigate that. We will be offering concession service on board today's excursion, including popcorn and an assortment of snacks and beverages. At this time, we accept both cash and card-based payments, so that's good for you. The most expensive item on our menu is $2. So there's a lot of good stuff here for you. All right, for the background history on our train today, we're being pulled by our twin FL-9 locomotives. We've got 2014 on one end, we've got 2016 on the other end. There were only 60 of these FL-9 locomotives ever produced. The city of Grapevine actually does own 2 of them. We're very proud of that. They are massive pieces of machinery weighing in at over 38 tons each. So they are huge. They were built in 1960 by General Motors Electromotive Division. We currently have 3 classes of coaches, first class, touring, and economy. The first class coaches were built in 1925. The touring and economy coaches are built in 1927. All of our coaches have been restored as accurately as possible with a few modern conveniences like air conditioning and audio. They're decorated to reflect the golden age of the railroad. Now, the pride and joy of our Grapevine Vintage Railroad fleet is our steam locomotive, number 2248. We affectionately call her Puffy. Puffy is currently undergoing a rebuild following her required periodic federal inspection, but she is scheduled to be on the rails with us again very, very soon. We are anxiously awaiting her return to duty because Puffy is 126 years old. She was built in 1896 by the Cook Locomotive Works in Paterson, New Jersey. She is the oldest operating steam locomotive in the state of Texas. Let's sit back and just relax and enjoy the rest of your ride. From all of us to all of you guys, welcome aboard.
Right. Absolutely, yes. You're going down or are you going to take it or?
Stockyards station, we'd like to thank you for riding with us today. We are going to ask that you remain in your seats until the train comes to a complete stop and our conductor gives us the signal that it is safe to begin unloading the train. The coach tends will direct you to the nearest exits and help you down the stairs to the ground inside the station. If you're interested in catching that Longhorn cattle ride, that takes place right at 4 o'clock. As you exit the train, turn to your right, and all the way to the end of the building, you'll be able to catch that. At 4:15, don't forget to catch the Legends of Texas Gunfight. That takes place directly on the tracks right inside the building as soon as that cattle drive goes by. Once again, thank you for
I'm not going to be able to do it.